Rally car enthusiast Mark is about to have his self-build skills pushed to the limit as he sets out to create a tiny vintage trailer home for him and his daughters in the back of a classic car. When looking for parts for his cherished collectible Saab, he discovered an almost identical model hidden away in a barn, except for one detail. It didn't have a front. But Mark's had a stroke of genius and decided if he added a tow bar to the front end, it could make the perfect tiny getaway for the family trip to the Le Mans 24-hour race in France.
Should we clamber in?
Well, we can try.
Is she gonna take my weight?
Yes, I think so.
I'll tell you what, mate, that is tiny. What are you gonna get in here?
Everything.
When you say
I've
everything,
got to get
like
it all in, I've got to get it all in, haven't I? There'll be no grand piano in there. That ain't gonna happen.
How much money have you got to spend on her?
Probably, in all fairness, by the time you buy all the bits and bobs, it's gonna be a couple of grand. But I think that's a couple of grand very well spent.
A couple of grand all in?
All in, I
reckon. Including the purchase of the vehicle.
Yeah.
Your new little fridge.
Yeah.
So you're probably looking at, what, £1,000 from this point on?
Yeah, I reckon so.
With custom caravan bills costing in the tens of thousands, bringing this micro-mobile home in on budget, and at the same time saving a piece of rare classic motoring history, will be an incredible achievement. I'm heading back to Chorley Wood, where for the last few months, Mark and his daughters have been spending every spare minute turning a battered back end of a Saab into a luxury micro-caravan. Mark's craftsmanship and restoration skills are evident across the exterior remodelling. But it's inside where his attention to detail really shines through.
Right, so, shall I get these cases out?
Yeah.
If it wasn't enough for Mark's retro camper to be cool, stylish, and timelessly classic, it's also a marvel of micro-engineering. With its double daughter-sized bed, consisting of two hinged wooden panels, pop-in slats, and the seat cushions for a mattress.
You just want to hope that, it's not raining in Le Mans, mate, when you have to do this.
If I have some pit stop practice, we get quicker and quicker.
He's done it.
I've no doubt the girls will love staying in their stylish camper. And to keep them even more comfortable, it still has a few more tricks up its sleeve. Starting with a number plate, which is hiding some plug-in power.
Oh, that's awesome.
Not to mention a super smart solar panel with an ingenious hidden plug.
Look at that. Plugs in. And then that'll charge your lights, your battery up in the day for at night, keep your fridge going, keep your beers cold.
Fully off-grid.
Proper.
Power generation.
Yeah.
That is brilliant.
But the best is yet to come.
This is the bit I've actually been waiting for.
Yeah.
Because you think we did that little mock-up about how it might work.
Yeah.
How well does it work?
One. Come on. Fully functioning kitchen.
It's brilliant.
Mark's pop-out kitchenette has Master Craftsman written all over it. He's taken the phrase mod cons quite literally with an original 1960s camping stove, not to mention plenty of storage and even a mini fridge.
I absolutely love it. I do, every single part of it, not just the way you've designed its functionality, which is brilliant.
Yeah.
But the look of it.
Put your deck chairs either side of the fridge, open it up, get your beer out, cock on.
But it feels vintage.
Yeah, that's what I try to aim for, really.
That is a fantastic piece of design.